Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. It is your girl Angel Baby and I am back with another video. Please make sure you like, subscribe, and you want to hit that notification bell so that way anytime I drop a video you will be notified. Okay y'all, I am so saddened by this. Wendy Williams, her dream New York City penthouse, sold by her guardian for a loss. Okay, she lost after she is deemed incompetent. Yep, that's right, incompetent. Now we all know how much Wendy cherished that Manhattan penthouse, y'all. That was her dream of bold and it was sold. Now the transaction closed on May 10th and she's only had the property for a few years. She hasn't even had it that long, y'all. This is just the latest chapter in Wendy's ongoing legal battles, personal challenges, after she was diagnosed in 2023 with primary progressive aphasia and frontotemporal dementia. Like, Wendy cannot get a break. Now, records accessed by the Post indicate that Wendy, 59 years old, was deemed incompetent, thus making it necessary for the involvement of the guardian and the decision making in the process regarding the sale of her residence. Now, the 3-bedroom, 3-bathroom penthouse traded hands for $3.75 million, y'all. With that is crazy because Wendy bought it for $4.5 million in 2021, making a considerable decrease of $822,000. Oh, hell nah. Prior to the sale, Wendy got rid of all her belongings, you guys, that was in that property, including her iconic purple chair and some of her Hot Topic segment cards and things that we've seen and has captivated her audience for years. That is so sad. It's like she's just selling herself in a sense. Now, we know how much Wendy loved being on the show, how much she talked about coming back to television. And it's really sad because, unfortunately, it is never going to happen. I mean, with this disease that she has, there is no getting better. It just progresses and progresses until eventually you cannot talk, you can't read, you can't write, you can't communicate. You're basically deteriorating. Your brain is shrinking. It is so, so sad. So that's what I'm thinking. I feel like that's the reason why they're selling all her belongings and, you know, her property is because I feel like Wendy is probably going to be in a residential treatment. You know, she's already been there for a while and there has been no other updates as far as her being out on her own. Wendy is being deemed incompetent. So it's basically like, she's just there, you guys. And we all know that there has to be something really going on with Wendy because Wendy would never, ever get rid of her purple chair. She wouldn't get rid of her apartment. She always talked about it. You guys, it's also being said that Wendy owes more than $500,000 in unpaid taxes, which also resulted in a federal tax lien. Now, Wendy's luxury apartment, you guys, is so nice. The main level has a spacious living room with a dining room area, open kitchen with custom stained walnut cabinetry. It's just absolutely gorge. Now, the upper level is basically Wendy's primary suite, you know, where her room is, and she has all these wonderful fixtures and marble accents, and it's just real artsy up there. Now, in addition to all these lavish interiors, the building has an array of amenities, including a fitness center and a water club, featuring a 60-foot lap pool and a sauna, a steam room, and a jacuzzi. Oh my God, I sound like I'm selling this pad, you guys. It's just a sad situation because it just seems like Wendy had everything, you know? Like, she had money. She had so much money that people were literally, aka Kevin, living off her and trying to take what she had. And now it's just like everything is gone. everybody is gone. It really makes you wonder. Life is crazy. I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. I really want to know your guys' thoughts and opinion on this whole situation. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Till next time. Bye, guys.